Good afternoon, students. This is Shubhakar P, Assistant Professor for the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. For you, in this semester, I am going to teach the subject, and the subject name is Analog Electronics. As you belongings to EEE, which stands for Electrical and Electronic Engineering, where it is a combination of both electrical and electronics. EEE, it is a combination of electrical and electronics. You should not believe that EEE is completely belonging to electrical. It is a combination of electrical and electronics. So that means the electronics subjects you have to study in this 4 years, as you are going to study the electrical subjects. The electronic subjects starts from the first subject is analog electronics. Analog electronics. In this class, I am going to explain what is electronics and what is analog electronics, some of the applications of electronics. After that, I am going to explain what are the 5 units we have. In that 5 units, what are the things we are going to discuss in coming classes, I am going to cover in this video. Definition of electronics and what is electronics, some of the applications of electronics, and what are the things we are going to cover, what are the things we are going to discuss in this entire analog electronics in 5 units, I am going to explain now. First one, I am taking the word is called electronics. I am taking electronics. Electronics. Electronics is a science, or it is one branch of engineering which completely deals with the semiconductors. Semiconductor, that means what? We are having one particular material. By applying some voltage or some electric field or some magnetic field to that semiconductor, we are going to study its response. We are going to study its output. We are going to analyze it. And this complete thing is called electronics. Electronics is a science. Electronics is one branch of engineering which deals with semiconductor materials. Semiconductor materials. Every day we have been using many electronic devices or electronic components unknowingly. Unknowingly we are using many electronic components in daily lives. Mobile phone, it is an electronics. TV, it is an electronic. Remote, it is an electronic. Washing machine, it is an electronic. Likewise, if you go with the daily lives, we are depending on more electronic equipment to get the flexibility, to get the advantage, to have the ease of living. We are depending on electronic devices. And all this, whatever I have given the examples, all comes under electronic equipment or electronic devices. According to the definition of electronics, Electronics is a science which deals with the semiconductor. That means all these equipments are having some of the internal components which made up of semiconductors. Semiconductor, in the definition, we are striking on one particular word, that is called semiconductor. Semiconductor. It is clear from the definition of electronics. Electronics is a science which deals with the semiconductor material, which deals with the semiconductor materials. Then what is semiconductor? Which deals with the semiconductor material. That means what? Dealing means what? By taking the semiconductor, we have been applying some voltage, then we are going to study its response with respect to the current or voltage and the influence of magnetic or electric field. That means what? Our complete focus of electronics we have to put on the semiconductor. Semiconductor, that means what? Semiconductor is a substance. It is a substance which acts as conductor sometimes, which acts as insulator sometimes. That means what? Same material. The same material or same substance will act as conductor in some time, and the same material acts as insulator in other times. Semiconductor, it conducts, it acts as a conductor and it acts as insulator. It acts as both. Based on the given conditions, based on the given inputs, the same material can act as a conductor as well as insulator. Then I am explaining what is electronics, in which we found the important word is semiconductor. In the semiconductor definition, again we found the two more words, that is conductor and insulator. Then what is conductor? Conductor is a material which conducts well amount of current, which is a material which allows the current, which allows the current, which allows the flow of electrons and the influence of voltage, electric field, magnetic field. So another word we came across, that is called insulator. Conductor is a material which conducts the current, which allows the current, whereas insulator is a material which does not conduct any current. Which does not conduct any current, that means what? If you give the any amount of voltage at any temperature, it won't conduct any current. So that insulators can be mainly used as dielectric material, dielectric material. It is not going to allow the current. It is not going to allow the electricity, so that it is called dielectric material. So in this, whatever so far we have explained, we came across what is electronics. What is electronics? I have explained. Electronics is a science in which we can discuss the semiconductor, we can deal with the semiconductor in presence of electric and magnetic field or the voltages. By applying these voltage, then what will be its response, and we have to analyze. That is called electronics. This complete phenomenon is called electronics. Electronics is a science which deals with semiconductors. And from the definition of electronics, we found one word is very, very important. That is semiconductor. Semiconductor. Semi means partial. Semiconductor. Semiconductor is a substance. Semiconductor is a substance. Sometimes it conducts the current, and in other times it don't conduct, it cannot conduct the current. It won't conduct the current. It won't conduct any current. The same material only. Sometimes it is acting as a conductor and sometimes it is acting as an insulator. So that we can call it is semiconductor, partial conductor. Sometimes it has been conducting, sometimes it has it not has been conducting any current. So that it is called semiconductor. And the best examples for the semiconductor, best example for the semiconductor, all the fourth group elements in the modern periodic table, all the fourth group elements in the modern periodic table, we can classify them as semiconductors. The best examples for the semiconductor, carbon, silicon, and germanium. These three are the best examples for the semiconductor material. That means what? These three materials can conduct the current in some time and it won't allow the current in other times. That means what? Carbon, whose atomic number is 6, silicon, whose atomic number is 14, germanium, whose atomic number is 32. Electronics we have defined. From that we found the important word is semiconductor. In this semiconductor, the best examples for the semiconductors. What is the definition of semiconductor? It is a partial conductor. Sometimes it conducts the current, other times it don't conduct, it won't conduct the current. And in the semiconductor definition, semiconductor, the definition of the semiconductor, if you know the semiconductor, it acting as a conductor and it acting as the same material is acting as an insulator also. That means what? From this one, again you can define the two more materials. One is conductor. It is a conductor. Next material is called insulator. Next material is called insulator. Semiconductor is a substance which conducts current in partial. Sometimes it conducts the current, sometimes it won't conduct the current. And whereas conductor conducts the current, conductor is a material which conducts the current. It conducts well amount of current. The best example for conductor is a copper, magnesium, aluminium. All these are metals. All these are metals. All the metals in the world is good conductor. All the metals in the world are good conductors. And you can take any example for this one. Copper is the best example. Aluminium is the best example. Magnesium is also best examples for the conductor. The next one is insulator. Next one we are going with insulator. Insulator is a material which does not conducts any current. That means what? The current through the insulator is not possible. Is not possible. Then I am going through one sequence. I am going through one sequence now. Going through one sequence from conductor to insulator I am going. Conductor, first I am going with the conductor. Conductor is a substance which conducts well amount of current. Which conducts well amount of current, that current is in amperes. The units for current is what? Amperes. What are the units for voltage? Volts. That means what? The conductor conducts well amount of current, that is in amperes. Whereas insulator doesn't conduct any current, so that the current through the insulator is zero. Conductor conducts well amount of current, and whereas insulator conducts zero amount of current. This is high current, it is absolutely zero current. And in between these two material we have our semiconductor. Semiconductor is a substance which conducts the current, which conducts the current, and that current is less than the current of conductor and more than the current of insulator. This is very, very valid point. Semiconductor is a substance. Semiconductor is a substance which conducts the current, which conducts the current, is less than the current of conductor and more than the current of insulator. Here it is conducting amperes current, here it is conducting zero current. In between amperes and zero, we can have the current of a semiconductor. That current is in milliamps or in microamps. Conductor is conducting the current is in amperes. Insulator is conducting no current. In between the conductor and insulator, in between the conductor and insulator, we have one material that is called semiconductor. Semiconductor conducts the current. Semiconductor conducts the current, which is less than the current of conductor and more than the current of insulator in terms of milliamps to microamps. Milli means what? 10 power of minus 3. This is what? 10 power of minus 6. That means what? The semiconductor conducts the current which is 1000 times less than the conductor. 1000 times less than the conductor. That means what? Here this fan is made up of all the conductors, so that copper wire is taking the current of 1 ampere. Whereas mobile is also conducting the current internally due to the battery. That current in terms of milliamps. That means electronic devices works with very small amount of current in terms of milliamps and microamps, whereas electrical devices works with conductor and it works with the more current, that current in terms of amperes. Here the very valid point I am explaining, that is, any material in the world can be classified into three, that is solid, liquid and gaseous form of matter. And again in the solids, again we can go with the three more classifications: conductor, semiconductor and insulator. All these comes under solids only. Three types. There are three classes in the solids. One is conductor, next one is semiconductor, next one is insulator. Conductor is, all the metals are the good examples for the conductor, which conducts the current in terms of amperes, 1 ampere. Whereas insulator doesn't conduct any current, so that it won't conduct any current, so that current will be zero. But in between we have the semiconductor which conducts the current is less than the current of conductor and more than the current of insulator, that in terms of milliamps and microamps. Again we can go with one more important point, is that here it is conducting more current and it is conducting very very less current, that is absolutely zero current. It is offering zero current. Zero current means it has been offering infinite resistance. That insulator has been offering infinite resistance for the current flow. Very infinite resistance it is offering, so that there is no current. Here it has been conducting the current is very high, so that this has been offering very negligible resistance. Resistance of this conductor is approximately equals to zero. There is no resistance for the current conduction through the conductor, so that current is more, so that resistance is zero. Here it has been offering huge resistance for the current conduction, so that there is no current, so that insulator offers no current. And in between we have in conductors and insulators we have semiconductor. Semiconductors offers the resistance which is more than the resistance of conductor and less than the resistance of insulator. It is offering infinite, it is offering zero. Now in between this, that means what? More than this resistance and less than this resistance, that is called semiconductor. Then semiconductor, electronics is completed, definition of electronics is completed. This is science which deals with semiconductor. Then what is semiconductor? Then what are the three examples for the semiconductor? Then with respect to the current, it is less than the current of conductor and more than the current of insulator. With respect to the resistance, it is more than the resistance of insulator and less than the resistance of insulator. This is about electronics. But our topic is to discuss analog electronics. Analog electronics, that in short we can call it is AE. AE subject, that is called analog electronics. That means what? Analog electronics. Analog. Analog means continuous in its nature, is called analog. That means what? When a signal is varying with respect to the time continuously, then that is called analog signal. For example, and this is analog signal. This is an analog signal. Here this is T, and this is amplitude, that may be voltage or current also. That means what? Or temperature also. From here to here, the temperature is continuously varying with respect to the time, and this type of signal is named as analog signal. By applying this type of signals as an input for the semiconductor materials, then we have to analyze its behavior. That is called analog electronics. That means what? In this complete 5 units, you are going to study the response, or you are going to study the output of a given semiconductor device by applying the analog signals. By applying the analog signals, we have to study the response of a semiconductor component or a device at various cases. That is analog electronics. And I am going to explain some of the important applications of electronics. The very first application of electronics, it makes the rectification. How many? So, I am going to explain some of the important applications of electronics. So far we have discussed what is electronics and what is the necessity of semiconductor, what are the examples of semiconductor, how the solids can be classified into semiconductor, conductors and insulators. We have discussed the semiconductors, conductor, insulator with respect to their conductivity and resistivity. And after that I have given what is analog electronics. Then I am going to explain some of the important applications of electronics. Applications of electronics. First important application of electronics is called rectification. Rectification. That means by using electronic components or electronic device, we can achieve the rectification. Rectification is a process of converting alternating current to direct current. Alternating current to direct current. Then I am going to give the explanation about this one. For example, I am having the mobile. I need to charge this mobile. So that to charge this mobile, I require to have one power socket, and I require to connect that power socket with the mobile charger. This is a mobile charger and it is a power socket, and this is a mobile. Mobile is, we know that it is an electronic device. Here this charger is taking the voltage. This charger is connected with a one particular power supply, that is called AC power supply. AC stands for alternating current. But we cannot directly connect this AC to the mobile. This AC has to be converted into some other form. Then only this mobile is going to be biased, or mobile is going to charge. That means what? The mobile requires one type of voltage source, whereas this power socket is having another type of power source. So that here we require a device. It has to convert alternating current to DC current. DC stands for direct current. Here we are using a mobile charger which is taking the input of AC and it is converting into the DC. The process of converting AC to DC is called, process of converting AC to DC is called rectification. Process of converting AC to DC is called rectification. The device which is converting AC to DC is called rectifier. The first unit you are going to discuss with the rectifiers. If you open the mobile charger, you will find the some electronic components like diode. PN junction diode you can find, Zener diode you can find, you can find some capacitors, some resistors. All these components were integrated together to convert alternating current to DC current, alternate AC to DC. The process of converting AC to DC is called rectifier, rectification. The device which converts AC to DC is called rectifier. In the rectifier, the main component is diode. Diode is a electronic component which made with the help of semiconductors. The first application of semiconductor is called rectification. Second application of electronics is called amplification. Amplification. Amplification, the definition of amplification, it is a process of increasing the strength of the electrical weak signal, that is called amplification. In generally, we will have some public addressing meetings. The speaker is going to speak here, where the remaining people has to listen from far distance. In such cases, we will use the amplifiers. Amplifier is going to boost up the input signal and it increases the strength of that signal and it delivers that. The best example for amplifier is loudspeaker. In front of the mic, we will speak with the normal voice only. When it comes from the loudspeaker, we can get the bigger voice compared to the original one. This is called amplification. The process of converting, the process of increasing the strength of the weak signal, is called amplification. The device which increase, the strength of the weak signal, that is called amplifier. Loudspeaker is the best example for the amplifier. If you open the amplifier circuit, you will find some electronic components called transistor. Transistor is a electron, is an electronic component which can made with the help of semiconductors only. Electronics, as we discussed, electronics is a science which deals with the semiconductor, Here we are saying transistor also semiconductor, so that transistor only making the amplification, so that one of the application of electronics is called amplification. First one is what? Rectification. Another one is amplification. And third one is called oscillation. Third application of electronics is called oscillations. Oscillation is nothing but making the oscillations at one frequency and which describes some functionality of any device. We heard about this ECG. ECG stands for electrocardiogram, which is used to describe the functionality of human heart. By keeping one type of device on the chest, we can see the functionality of the human heart by using a graph. By generating a signal, at one particular frequency is called oscillation. These type of things we can achieve by making use of the electronics. And the last application of the electronics is called control and automation. By using the remote, you can control the any one of the electronic device. For example, by using the remote, I can control the volume of a TV. By using the same remote, I can change the channels from one channel to another channel. I am controlling with the electronic device. Last one is automation. For example, if you go to the petrol pump and if you ask to fill your tank with the 100 rupees, he simply type 100 rupees and he will pour the, he will put the pipe into the tank, so that after filling the 100 rupees, automatically it stops. That means what? All these applications comes under electronics. So that here I have discussed the five applications. First one is rectification. Next one is amplification. Next one is oscillation. and the last one is control and automation. And this is the complete brief introduction about the analog electronics. In the next class, I am going to start the first unit, which is nothing but PN junction diode. Thank you.